सी, एक कहावत है कि इंसान खुशी के लिए अपना घर बदलता है, नौकरी बदलता है, साथी बदलता है,
लिबास बदलता है,
दोस्त बदलता है, लिबास बदलता है,
फिर भी परेशान है।
पर फिर भी कभी सुखी नहीं रहता, हमेशा परेशान रहता है, क्योंकि इंसान अपने आप को नहीं बदलता। तो आज का जो मेरा
इसीलिए
टॉक
कबीर
है,
गालिब ने लिखा है, जिंदगी क्यों परेशान हो वाला, धूल चेहरे पे थी और आईना साफ कर रहा है।
बस बात वही है, धूल चेहरे पे, साफ आईना कर रहे हैं। तो बेसिकली माय टॉक टुडे विल बी ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर, एज इट इज एंगर हेल्थ एंड एनएलपी, एंड अगेन व्हेन वी से न्यूरो लिंग्विस्टिक प्रोग्रामिंग, आई हैव टेकन सम टेक्निक्स ऑफ एनएलपी। एक्चुअली आई एम एन एनएलपी प्रैक्टिशनर, सर्टिफाइड एनएलपी प्रैक्टिशनर एंड कोच, सो आई विल टेक अ फ्यू टेक्निक्स ऑफ दैट एंड अप्लाई। लेकिन फर्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू नो, आई मीन ऑल ऑफ यू आर कंफर्टेबल, ऑल ऑफ यू आर कंफर्टेबल विद इंग्लिश, योर
वेरी गुड, इट्स गुड।
गुड, देन कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ एंगर, व्हाट डू यू थिंक, व्हाट इज एंगर?
टॉर्चरिंग योर सेल्फ,
टॉर्चरिंग योर सेल्फ, वेरी नाइसली सेड। एनीबडी एल्स?
लूजिंग कंट्रोल,
लूजिंग कंट्रोल, ओके, व्हाट अबाउट यू सर? डोंट वांट टू से एनीथिंग?
एक्चुअली व्हेन यू आर एंग्री यू हर्ट नोबडी बट योरसेल्फ।
व्हेन यू आर एंग्री यू हर्ट नोबडी बट योरसेल्फ, दैट्स वेरी राइट। व्हाट अबाउट यू सर?
एंगर इज एंगर,
एंगर इज एंगर,
कांट चेंज
इट, राइट? सो बेसिकली इट इज पनिशिंग योरसेल्फ फॉर व्हाट समवन एल्स हैज डन। You see, you haven't done something wrong, but somebody else has done something wrong, and then you are, that is what we call as anger. Somebody else has done which is wrong in your opinion. Right? The point is my opinion correct? I think what somebody else did is wrong. Today when I was driving, there were a couple of guys on the two-wheeler actually cutting across. Maybe they were in more hurry than I was. But the point is, was it really worth getting angry, or is it saying, okay, take it easy here, you go ahead, come on, I don't mind waiting a few seconds or a minute or whatever. Because again, he's done something wrong, in my opinion. But if you ask him, he says, no, what he's done is right. Right? So the question is, what about other people's opinion? Anger is one letter short of danger, very rightly said. So anger is associated with danger. We'll see how. This is what I was telling you. Is your opinion correct? That's the first question. Maybe, maybe not. And then the second is, what about others' opinion? Even they could be right in their opinion. Right? Their opinions. Everybody has a right to have an opinion, and everybody has an opinion. In fact, everybody gives you his opinion, whether you want it or not. Why we get angry? Yes, do you agree to this? Desires and expectations are not met. I want something, I don't get it. I expect something from somebody else and I don't get it. That makes me angry. So my desires and my expectations are not being met from others. Desires from my life probably, expectations from others. Right? Something happens, somebody else does something, sometimes you do something, but generally somebody else. Event or a provocation, as I said, you know, a two-wheeler cutting, it's an event. Everything happening, even right now when I'm talking to you, it's an event. Right? It could be a provocation, somebody even provoking you to get angry. Possible, because people know you behave in a particular way. The person knows they behave in a particular way and you will get angry. This is saying, you know, the control is, your control is outside. So they will give you that provocation. They will do something to make you angry. What are the bad effects of anger? First, as it says, is disrupts one's life. Controls your thoughts. Do you really think rationally when you are angry or not? No, you generally don't think rationally. You cannot think rationally. So anger is actually controlling your thoughts. Right? Ruins relationships. How many times have friends or even couples separated Probably cases I have gone to divorce also because of anger. Even friends stop meeting each other, stop talking to each other because they get angry. So anger is a major, playing a major role in ruining these relationships. Causes pain. Right? I'll go into the health effects of it. I mean, what all we can suffer because of anger. But basically it does cause pain. Causes health problems. I'll be going into details of that. Causes, what is that? Causes emotional problems. Sorry. Again, you understand emotional problems, isn't it? You are not emotionally stable, right? And then you say something which the other person doesn't like. Later on, you may repent. But a word said is said. Even if you repent, it's not going to give you any chance to take your word back. Right? Banduk se goli nikal gayi, zaban se shabd nikal gaya. Platform se train nikal gayi, tu nikal gayi. Uska pisha karke koi fayda nahi, you cannot get it back. Leaves negative impressions. In fact, when we are in a negative frame of mind or negative impressions are affecting us, we can't think positive. We will not be able to think positive if we are in a negative frame of mind. Remember, in NLP, one of the things is what we call is state of mind. Now, what is that state of mind? It is, in different terms, we use different terminology. In very simple, if I need to explain you, I can give you an example of the term focus. In cricket, we use, the term form. In cricket, we use the word form. He is in form or he is out of form. Any player, let's say Yuvraj Singh. He's got his shots in his kitty. He knows which ball, how to hit to get a 6 or to get a 4. When he is in form, he clicks. And he is able to dispatch those balls for 4 and 6. When he is not in form, he doesn't click. He gets out. The same ball which he could hit for a 6 in the previous match when he was in form. If he is not in form, he cannot play that ball. He gets out on that ball. Right? So same way, that is the negative impression. Not being in form is negative impression. Being in form is positive impression. So if you are in form, as I said, you can tap your resources. If you are in a positive frame of mind, you can tap your resources. We always have resources. It is not that we don't have. But we are not able to tap them when we are in the negative frame of mind. That is why people will tell you, I know I shouldn't have shouted, but I shouted.
It doesn't help.
It doesn't help. Exactly, right? That the moment is over. The diseases which are caused by anger are here. As it says, dis-ease. That means you are not at ease. If you are not at ease, disease. That's the interpretation. From common cough, cold to heart problems, diabetes, cholesterol, arthritis, and even cancer. Anger can reach to that stage. How, we will see in the next slide. 20 years of anger can cause cancer. Now, when I say 20 years, I just like to clarify. When a person gets angry, for how much duration is he angry? 5 minutes, let's say. A few seconds, no, I don't think so.
Couple of minutes normally.
Normally.
The after effects of it is very...
Yeah, no, I'm talking of that immediate. Immediate is about, let's say, 5 minutes.
A minute and a half, because your speed is so high.
Okay. So, let's say 2 minutes.
That should be a reasonable time.
And how many times do you get angry in a day?
Many times. If you go to see many
times. Yeah. So, how many times? What figure should I take? I want it from you all.
At least 15 to 20 times.
So, 2 minutes into, let's say, 20 times?
Mr. Mehra, really? Do we are taking 20 times?
A little thing. Even see, from when a two-wheeler comes between the stops.
See, when I say anger, the lowest form of anger is irritation.
Yes.
You know, like now you're sitting, if you move your leg and he gets disturbed, he gets irritated. That is also anger. It is a lower form of anger. Of course,
spot anger.
And the highest form of anger is revenge. There are different stages, you know, irritation is there, couple of other stages in between, then there is anger, finally it is revenge. Because if you want to take revenge from somebody, you will be angry for that many years till you take revenge. Sometimes I have seen people, even my friends, when they are driving cars. Believe me, earlier I used to do that. Now I have controlled myself. But if somebody overtakes me, I would speed up, go ahead, overtake him, stop him there and then tell him, what are you doing? What you are doing is wrong. And he just nods his head and he goes away. What have I achieved? But that revenge thing, you know, road rage. And that was, that revenge was on for about 10 minutes, 20 minutes. That anger was at the highest stage.
You didn't kill them.
No, I didn't. I felt like, but I didn't. So basic issue is that, you know, that is the highest stage of anger. So now idea is calm down, cool down, doesn't make sense because he just nods his head and he goes away. That's it.
Okay.
Maybe not even heard it, especially because you're wearing a helmet, not bothered. So I was saying 2 minutes of anger into 20 times a day.
Nowadays, AC cars, they don't even hear you.
Yeah. Now, I was talking of two-wheelers wearing headphones, the helmet.
Car.
Yeah, but you put the car glass down and tell him and he doesn't hear you. Anyway, this is 40 minutes per day, right? And then multiply this by 30. 30 days a month. 12 months in a year. I am talking of minutes into 20 years. minutes. You are angry that much in 20 years, right? 20 years. And that could lead to cancer. Where? Oh, yes. Sorry, my mistake. I appreciate that everybody is listening to me. 2,88,000 minutes in 20 years. In 20 years, you are angry for 2,88,000 minutes. Considering that you are angry only 2 minutes every time you get angry and 20 times in a day. Hypothetical figure, obviously. It's not something very standard. But this is what we are trying to say, that when you say you're angry for the last 15, 20 years, it could be 3 lakh minutes, it could be 2 lakh minutes, it could be somewhere there. Right? Yeah. 10 years can cause you heart problems. Obviously, 10 years, let's say 1.5 lakh minutes, that could cause you heart problems. 5 years, arthritis. 1 year of anger can cause diabetes. Just 1 year. And 1 year means we are looking at this. Say 14,400 minutes. That's 1 year. 1 year of anger can give you diabetes. 1 month of anger can give you gas problems, ulcers. 1 month. Gas problems, ulcers, people have it.
Gastric upsets.
Gastric upsets, very right. 1 day of anger can give you throat irritation, cough. So as I said, starts from throat irritation and cough and can go up to cancer.
Is this repressed anger? Is this anger which are repressing ones that you're talking about or any anger?
Any anger. Whether you suppress it or whether you express it, anger is anger. That's a myth, believe me. Because when you say you express it, you are angry, you are expressing it, you are throwing anger onto somebody else.
Okay. I agree with you, but which is of the two evils, which is a better evil? Suppression or throwing out?
Sir, if you are throwing out anger, you are angry, the other person gets angry and he will give you anger back.
Okay.
Right? If you suppress it, then again it can give you a lot of things. So the idea is, in the end I will tell you how not to get angry. So I'll come to that stage.
Suppression also is dangerous, right?
Suppression is equally dangerous. Expressing is equally dangerous. Both are dangerous. It's a myth to say one is better than the other.
Both are
equally bad. 1 minute of anger is healthy.
Nonsense.
You get angry, 1 minute and then it's over. Good. Then you're healthy. 5 seconds of anger and you are an enlightened person. Because what I'm trying to say here is, it is not that people don't get angry. People do get angry. But if you can change your response immediately within those 5 seconds and cool down the situation, you are an enlightened person.
What about a person who never gets angry?
Sir, I have not come across any person who never gets angry even for 5 seconds.
I am one of
them. Let's see. I appreciate your this thing. If you don't get angry even for 5 seconds, good. Right? But as I said, what about irritation? Do you get irritated?
No.
No. Good. If you don't get irritated, also much better.
I don't think so.
That is your opinion. What about others' opinion, sir? I started with that.
You need to
ask your family, ask your friends, somebody, as you are saying, somebody close to you can tell you whether you get angry or not. Yeah. Okay. So my question is, what should we say? No, people say anger management. I don't like the word management with anger. The simple reason is, I would like to manage my family, manage my finances, manage my job, manage my holidays, because all this gives me pleasure. Why should I manage anger, which is not going to give me pleasure? So instead of anger management, I should have written there anger control or anger eradication. If somebody doesn't get angry, very nice. So it should be reduction of anger, control of anger. But somehow I don't use that term, because everybody talks of anger management. And if I say anger control, then people look at me and say, what do you mean? What is anger control?
How?
And then they say, no, it is anger management. And today the MBA, management in business administration. Yeah, that's the buzzword. So I have to go with the buzzwords. So my question is it anger management or self-management? What are we talking about?
Self-management.
It is not anger. We are not managing anger really. We are actually managing our own selves. We are going to tell ourselves not to get angry.
Self-control.
Suppose in a talk, somebody has accidentally, his mobile is ringing. So I tell that person, switch off your mobile. Is it anger or is it irritation?
It depends on how you talk.
If you
tell him, please put your mobile on silent without getting angry. The question is, are you irritated by his sound? If you are irritated, that is one form of anger.
I agree. Yeah. That's
what I said.
Yeah. I agree.
In fact, it will be more than 20, sir. Believe me. You said 20. I've kept it there.
But
believe me, it will be more than 20.
A really enlightened person will not bother if you want.
He will not bother.
It comes and goes, but...
He will not bother.
The effect is the same.
In fact, he may at the most tell him, if you don't mind, could you put it on silent? It was disturbing me. That's about it. So it's not that he doesn't want to tell him. He wants to tell him, but he will tell him in a much better way. Basically, it is how you respond is how you are going to be able to control your anger.
And he may not.
He may not. He may not. That is his choice.
So you're multiplying a particular...
If he doesn't, then you get more angry.
Yes.
More irritated. It happens. It happens to everybody. So as I said, even enlightened persons do get angry. That's why I put 5 seconds for enlightened persons. They do get angry. Okay. Situations don't make you angry. It is how you respond to a situation which makes you angry. Yeah. I'll give an example to this. Let's say you're sitting at home, maybe a young man sitting at home. Ready to go to the office. Okay, I'm there, ready to go to office. And sitting there having coffee, finish my breakfast. After coffee, I'm going to pick up my bag and go to the office. And then suddenly my small daughter comes, tuck, she bangs the table. The coffee spills on my shirt. And what do I do? Don't you know how to behave? Drop the coffee on my shirt. And then I fire my wife. Can't you teach her manners? Is this how she behaves?
Spontaneous.
This will be the reaction. What will happen after the reaction?
Everything in the whole day goes bad.
Exactly.
I'll
still go up, change my shirt. Probably I'm already late. When I come down, my daughter has not had breakfast. She's, you know, wife has got a different face. I don't need to say what, but you can understand that. And with all that scenario going on, Then my wife tells me she's missed her school bus, so drop her to school. So I have to take her in the car to school. I drive into the school. Probably I enter a no entry lane. Why? Because I'm in a hurry. I wasted 5 minutes changing the shirt and other things. So I'm in a hurry. So I enter no entry lane. There's a cop standing there. So I have to pay 200 rupees or whatever fine. And then I go. Daughter reaches school late. And what does she do? All along in the car she's sitting. And when she gets down, opens the door, runs. Yeah, very much, very much. She'll open the door, run out straight to the school, not even look at me. After that, I reach office, and then I realize I have not taken my laptop today from home.
Beautiful.
Right? After that, I have reached also 10-15 minutes late to the office, so all those things have added up. Right? Evening when I get home, what happens? There is already a wedge between the relationship, between me and my wife, my daughter. They don't even want to talk to me. Right? What spoiled the day?
Coffee.
The coffee?
Reaction.
My reaction to that.
Reaction.
Exactly. Exactly.
Not the coffee,
so all that I should have done was, told her, you need to be careful, baby. This is not how you drop coffee. See, my shirt has got spoiled. Now I'll go and change. Anyway, you have breakfast, I'll change and come. By the time I go up, change my shirt, put on tie, whatever, and I'm down to take my laptop. Daughter's already having breakfast or had breakfast and she's leaving for the school bus. She waves goodbye. I land up in the office 5 minutes early and I wish everybody.
Sorry. And she'll say, I'm sorry.
Yeah. She will have already said sorry or she will, mom would have told her. Yeah. Mom would have told her when daddy comes, say sorry. So she will tell me, sorry daddy. It's okay, no problem. So she's happy, everybody is happy. Why? In the first few seconds, not even minutes, how I reacted. So it is not situations which make you angry, it is how you act in a situation that makes you angry.
How
you respond. So we need to change our responses. Again, as I said in the beginning, we change others, we want to or try to change others, but do we change ourselves? So this is about changing ourselves, not about changing others. It is easy to change your response if you decide to change.
Personal level, I said, be the energy you want to attract.
Exactly. You're very right, ma'am. Be the energy you want to attract. Whatever you give out to the world, you will get back the same thing.
Much more.
If I shouted at my daughter, the example which I gave, if I shouted at my daughter, imagine what I got back. If I had not shouted, what would I got back? So whatever you give, you will get back exactly the same thing. Right. So, get it back with interest. Very right. Very right. So you cannot change others, but you can change yourself. You can. Everything needs an effort. This also needs effort. If you're willing to make efforts, you will change yourself. That's not an issue. First and foremost, of course, since I also do corporate training, you might find words like, you know, employees and all in my presentation. But basically, as it says, don't catch your employees or children doing wrong things.
Catch them doing the right
thing. Exactly, sir. You were just one step ahead of what I was. So you took the words from my mouth, but very right. Because the idea of a good trainer is that he's able to convey things without saying. So if you can understand me that way, I think I'm doing a good job.
Pat on the back.
Thank you, sir. I'll pat my back. So, catch them doing right things. Remember, everybody does wrong and right both the things. Nobody wrong. In the world does only wrong or only right.
Even that is a perception at times. Wrong
yes,
and right.
Right and wrong is also a perception. But having said that it's a perception, even otherwise certain things are fixed. Like for example, traveling ticketless in a train is wrong. Now, if your child or somebody, of course, I know they will not. But just in case they do something such, don't be after them. Later on, you can correct them, not immediately. And when he does take a ticket, next time you explain him, he takes a ticket, pat his back. Good job. You're an honest citizen. Not only that, even otherwise children, sometimes they're going out and playing. Sometimes they come in and study. So don't just catch them doing wrong things. Playing, get in. Of course, today they don't go out to play, they play on the mobile. Isn't today you have to actually tell them, go out and play.
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what I mean.
Yeah, good job done.
Yeah, don't come yeah. home,
but
not so soon.
Not so. Yeah. So that's important. Catch them doing right things, that will make you happy. When you want to get things done, use creative ways to remind people. As I say, they tend to forget conveniently. Come. See, people will give you excuses to say why they didn't do something. I forgot. And you can make out that they have forgotten conveniently. They did not forget, but they forgot. Exactly. Selective memory loss. This is the only thing I forgot, Mama. Rest everything I remembered. Right? So there will be selective memory loss, as she rightly pointed out. So basic idea is use creative ways. What creative ways? Maybe before you come home, give a call on the mobile itself, sitting in the rickshaw or something. Not when you are driving. If you are driving, please don't use the mobile. But sitting in the rickshaw, or nowadays Ola Uber is available, sitting there, you can always call home. Have you done this? If not, please do it. Right? So, ways of reminding. Maybe postage are available today. You can put those postage somewhere. Something of that sort. So, you'll have to find different creative ways depending on what you want to remind people.
I would like to see if there's anything that they benefit out of doing a certain thing. If there's a benefit for them.
Yeah. Always.
Then they'll never forget.
That is a very big motivation for them. Yeah. Because if they benefit, then they will always want to do it. Yes.
A vested interest for them.
Yes.
To do it without even my reminding them.
No, in fact, one psychologist says that you should, reward them for every good they do. But then that may become a habit, and then they will not do good unless they are rewarded. That's something like bribing, yeah.
The act itself.
So within the act itself, yeah. They will remember.
Rewarding might not be in the sense of presence, but only a good appreciation. It's a reward.
Patting the back, good appreciation.
Good job, thank you, smile.
Yeah, that's also a good thing. So that's not really bribing, but then that's a good way of appreciating. And they will remember appreciation also. If they will remember your anger, they will also remember your appreciation. Right? Okay. They remember only 20% of what they hear. They don't remember everything. This is with everybody. Believe me, at the end of this session, you will not remember everything that you heard, but you will selectively remember whatever you paid extra attention to. Or, as I normally say, you want to remember. As I normally say, there are two modes. One is the hearing mode, one is the listening mode. In the hearing mode, you will even hear the traffic moving outside. That sound also you can hear. Horn. That is hearing mode. Door opening sound. That's hearing mode. Listening is where you are going to hear attentively. Yeah. You hear with concentration, hear with attention, and you process that information.
That is important.
That is listening.
Processing in my mind. Okay. How can I use this?
Yeah. Processing in your mind. Because ultimately your mind is the one which is working. Yeah. Exactly.
Otherwise,
there is too much of information in today's day, overload. In fact, we have to be selective in choosing information. There is so much of overload of information, we have to be selective in how we, what information we want. Now, this is a checklist I have made for getting angry. As it says, if you can be angry with the right person, to the right degree, at the right time, for the right purpose, and in the right way, then be angry. So when you want to be angry, you can look at this checklist. Is it the right person? Is it the right degree? Is it the right time? I think it's already too much. Why go further? It's not worth getting angry. Right? So if you start making these few points, if I get angry, this is the criteria for me to get angry. Then you will say it's not worth getting angry. Okay. Remember, a strong man is not one who can fight. Everybody today can fight. If not physically, at least with words. Right? It is somebody who can control his temper when angry. We are not talking of physical strength, we are talking of mental strengths. If you are mentally strong, then you are strong. If you are physically strong, it's of no use. Right. Quick guide now. Before I go into this, I want to tell you an incident in I'm working for an organization, and there I was taking the anger management session. I was not taking this session, it was our boss had called for a meeting, and my friend had promised, my colleague actually sits next to me, he had promised that he is going to take his wife out for a dinner and a movie. And that day the boss decided that we want to have a meeting after the office hours, after 5:30. We generally wind up by 5:30 or 6 o'clock. After that, so he says, no, today there will be a meeting after this, so we want to be here. When the meeting got over, it was around 8 o'clock. And then he turns around and he tells me, he says, boss, you talk a lot about anger management and stress management and interpersonal skills. That seems to be your forte these days. Now tell me, when I go home, my wife will be angry. How should I control my anger? Or how should I ensure that my wife doesn't get angry? I said, first and foremost is, you need to study the anger pattern and then change the pattern. He says, too theoretical. What do you mean study pattern? He says, I should take a book and start noting. I said, no, nothing doing. We'll do it practically. I said, okay. Give me, can you spare another 5 minutes? You're already late by 2 hours. He says, yes. If you can give me a good solution to my problem, I will give you 5 minutes. So I said, okay, I'll tell you something, you try it out. And I said, tell me, how does your wife get angry? He says, the moment I go and ring the doorbell, she will open the door and start shouting then and there. You told me you are taking me for dinner and movie, this is the time you come, this is how she will start. I said, and then what do you do? He says, I tell her, come on, here, go in, at least let me come in, I'm already tired, the office meeting. I said, so you also shout back? He says, yes. I said, you cannot change her. You change your response. So what you do is, when you are going home, buy one rose, but put it in your bag, she should not see it. Laptop bag or something, where she cannot see. It's the not the rose which is doing the trick, the rose is in the end. Also buy some nice 5-10 rupees packet cream biscuits. You get, why 5-10 rupees I am saying is because you don't want too many, just 3 or 4 biscuits is enough. But nice cream biscuits, maybe any, I don't want to use any brand names. I'm not advertising any brand, but good cream biscuits, 3 or 4 of them should be there in the packet, take that. And keep that packet in your hand. When your wife opens the door and starts shouting, this is the time you... Just one minute. Tell her, 1 minute, hold on, one minute. She will, you know, look at it. Let me come inside. I am also thirsty. And I brought biscuits. I'll have some biscuit water, then we'll fight. So what have you done? Her shouting is gone down. Your response has changed. So her response is changing. Now after you go inside, don't expect that she will bring water for you. So you go inside, keep your bag, get yourself a glass of water, sit down on the table or chair wherever you sit, open the packet, have a biscuit and tell her, darling, this biscuit is very nice. Why don't you try one? I'm angry and you're telling me, darling, I told you we'll fight. After we finish the biscuit and water, then we'll fight, no problem. But just have one biscuit. So you may have two, she may have one. It's okay. Drink water and tell her, darling, after biscuits, normally you feel like drinking water. Why don't you drink some water also? Now what have you done? The shouting which was supposed to be at the door is already here. Pattern is broken. And when the pattern is broken, there will be no more shouting. So, believe me, she will go and get a glass of water for herself. She will sit in front of you and drink. And when she had ate the biscuit and had the glass of water, the anger has gone down. Once the anger goes down, there will be no more shouting. And after that, after she's had water, before you talk, open your bag, take out the rose, give it to her and give her a big hug. Darling, I love you. No more anger after that. And he asked me, he says,
that is really what?
Yes. My colleague went home, he did all this, it worked, and next day he brought some homemade sweets, you know, some halwa or something, I don't remember exactly what, maybe suji halwa or something. And he says, my wife has made this, and she says, I must share it with you. Why? Because he says, the moment all that happened, and then I gave her a rose and I hugged her, there was no anger after that. And then she's asking me very coolly, what happened? As usual, my boss called for a meeting. I couldn't say no. I had to attend. It got late. And then he says, if you want, you can even call my colleagues and ask. She has my number also. What do you mean call colleagues? I don't trust you, is it? Then again, he said, no, let's take it easy. I don't mean that way, because that was shooting in again into anger. No, I don't trust you. That was what I was getting to. So he says, no, I don't mean that. I'm just saying that this is what happened. So the idea is, in fact, in NLP, what we study is patterns. There are patterns of different things. We need to break patterns of the bad things, and we need to implement patterns of the good things. We also use a word called modeling. In NLP, there are different techniques. Anchoring is there. Anchoring is basically, you see, anger, what happens is, sometimes it could be a past memory. You know, maybe 10 years back, somebody abused you or whatever it may be, and maybe the other person was a man in power, you could not get back. So it is settled in your unconscious mind, and every time you think of that person, you get angry. Just thinking, 10 years passed by, but you are angry, which means you are angry for 10 years. Arthritis. Remember that. Right? So the idea is, in NLP, anchoring is one of the techniques where we can get rid of this. There is another way where we get rid of past memories. So there are different techniques. One of the techniques is modeling. What is modeling basically? Modeling is to inculcate the behavior of the successful people. So a person who doesn't get angry, you see how he behaves. And inculcate. Mind you, it's inculcation, not copying. Nakal may be akal chahiye. So it is not copying, it is inculcating that behavior. Changing yourself internally. That's important. And in my colleague's case, as I told you, it worked. And in fact, I got some sweets next day. Homemade that too. So these things do work. Right?
What is full form of
NLP? NLP is neuro-linguistic programming. Yeah, basically it is dealing with our nervous system.
Why do couples fight? And you know what? Living relationship is much better than a marriage.
Yeah. See, basically what happens
is... Because I'm telling you, because I should not talk about my family. My son is in the 12-year-old living relationship. We are so happy. We have never fought. She has come home. He has gone home. But the moment the marriage certificate, there's something bad about the certificate.
It's not nothing bad about certificate. The basic issue is you take people for granted.
Because, you know, there was another case of a couple, sir, you know, 10 years they were living, and they were saying, oh, now we are very happy, I'm sure you must get married. And it's a true story, and then within 1 year, divorce took place.
Very right.
Like Angelina and Brad Pitt
also. Yeah, I was just going to say that, yeah.
They were together for 10 years.
So basically what happens is, you start taking the other person for granted.
This is the bad thing about marriage.
I'll tell you what happens. In marriage, if you are tired and you come home, you don't bother how much work your wife has done at home. You will just say, okay, make a cup of tea for me. Maybe she's tired, she's worked the whole day, or she's not feeling well, she's got some headache or not, whatever it may be. So she's already saying, what the hell, here? I'm tired. After coming back, instead of making tea for me, he's asking me to make tea. And you may also get a response, you know, hell with you, go and make your tea yourself and make one for me also. Right? So basically, but what will happen in a live-in relationship, it will not be that way. Because the fear is there that she might leave me and go. So when you come home, you will not straight away demand for tea. You will come home and say, how are you? Are you okay? Do you think you can make tea for me? So that change is there.
There is another thing also. The woman not only wants to be loved, she wants to be told that she is loved.
Yeah. That is another thing. I was just coming to that. That's the second point, is that, you know, expression is very important. You need to say, sometimes, you know, people say that, of course I love you. Where is the question of I don't love you? Yeah, but you never said it.
You have to prove it.
You never proved it. When was the last time people sitting here for your spouse? When was the last time you took a bouquet of flowers with you?
A dog never says, I love you, but he's wagging of his tail and keep all the Romeo Juliet's in the basket.
Exactly, very right. You see, that is again expression. Okay, let us put it like this, don't bring flowers. How many times have you gone home and hugged your wife last? When was the last?
Decades ago.
So that's expression, isn't it? So do it today and see what happens.
And you know, but is it, when we come home, the dog greets you first.
She might turn around and tell you, are you okay? Something which you never done, isn't it? Nothing wrong with you, no? Have you banged your car? That's another one. Who are you? who's using my wife's mobile and sending me these messages? Yeah, so as I was saying, the basic issue is if you we are all living life in a pattern. So if you are willing to break the pattern, you will get different results. In fact, NLP is all about that. How to break patterns, what to do, how to get rid of past memories, how to set goals in future. It's a big thing. I'm not going too much into that. But the technique which I used with my friend, with my colleague in the office, is a part of NLP. Basically, changing the pattern, studying that pattern and changing it. It has worked, right? Okay.
Mr. Bhatia,
yes, sir.
Can you elaborate? You said NLP deals with nervous system. Can you show some more light?
Yeah. See, basically, NLP deals with your, as it says, neuro-linguistic programming. It's your nervous system. Now, you see, what happens is, whatever we see is an event. Anything, even right now you are sitting and listening to me is an event. This event, you are going to register in your conscious mind first. Then you will start thinking about it, that is this event correct? That means what I am saying, does it make sense to you? And that would be by your unconscious mind. I am little deviating from here, from the anger part of it, just to answer his question. You see, basically, there is event number one, let's say. This event number one, we are sensing it with our eyes, we are seeing with our eyes, with our ears, I will say audible, let's say instead of eyes, I will use the term visual. So it's visual, auditory, it is also sensory, that means touch, taste, right, feeling. So all these things are actually five senses that we have. So we are going to sense this event by all the five, right? And actually feelings or emotions is the most important in this. So I'll put that emotions down. And then this event number one basically goes through a filter which we call as deletion, distortion and generalization. That means I will delete the information which I don't want. For example, if you came from home by a car to this place, you must have seen so many cars. Maybe you must have read a number of a few cars. But do you remember anyone now?
No.
No. So deletion. Distortion. Distortion is again something like what you have in your mind. No. What he is saying is okay, but I don't believe. Why? Because in the past it has happened like this. In my past, when somebody said this, this is what it meant. So I don't agree to what he says. So that is distortion, because it is already there in my mind. In my subconscious mind, it is already there. We also do a lot of generalization. If you said this, it means this. Interpretations. What do we say in terms? I would say X is equal to Y. That means When I walked in here, if you didn't get up, that means you don't respect me. I may not have got up for a different reason.
You got angry.
That can get related to anger. You got angry. So X is equal to Y. When I came home, you did not prepare tea for me, so you don't love me. X is equal to Y. Generalization.
You didn't say you love me, so you don't love me.
So you don't love me.
Generalization is even conditioning.
Generalization is the conditioning, very much. Assumptions.
Condition is the worst thing in life.
Sir, but it is there. I agree, it is not good.
Perception,
yes. See, we generalize, let's say, we generalize so many things. I'll give another example. Let's say, I go from my house to the station walking and I get pickpocketed. Right? After 2-3 months, I walk again, second time I get pickpocketed. After another 2 months, I go again, third time I get pickpocketed. This area, all pickpockets are staying. Now, consider that I was the only unlucky guy who got pickpocketed 3 times in the last 6 months in that area. Nobody else has ever been pickpocketed. But what generalization I will have?
Yeah,
ye area mein sab pickpocket rehte hain.
Yeah. A man is having whiskey and rum and water, whiskey and water, rum and vodka, vodka and water. So he can say the water is a one person that intoxicates.
Intoxicates everybody. So this generalization is applies in lot of things. You know, you will find people, I get this, some people come and tell me, everybody in my family hates me. Everybody? I just say that, everybody, and I keep quiet. And then you'll say, no, not everybody, but 3-4 people. Now in the family there are only 3-4 people? No, there are more. So that everybody has already come down to 3-4. But the generalization is what? Everybody. It happens once, it happens twice, at the most thrice, and there's a generalization. Everybody.
Everybody, every time.
Every time. Every time I come home, people fight with me. Every time I come home, my wife shouts at me. Every time. If you go out to bring some vegetables and come back again, she fights with you. Or she fights only when you're late. The day you go home early from the office, does she fight with you? So that every time. So these kind of generalizations are there. And after this generalization, it registers with us what we call as event number 2. Right? So basically, event 1 and event 2. Event 1 is the actual event, what happened. And event 2 is what I have registered.
The repercussions.
What I have registered. And these two are bound to be different. Right? So every time this happens, I will look at this because this is what settles in my unconscious mind. Ye area mein sab pickpocket rehte hain. So that's what is settled in my mind. Right? So basically what we are saying is this is how our system is working, our neurological system is working. They are not wired to remember negative. They are basically conditioned. Yeah, because of this. So if I see, I'll tell you something.
Maybe my husband was nice to me all the time, but one time on and off he got angry or whatever, disappointed. And I remember only that.
Exactly.
All the years.
See, I'll tell you why it happens. You see, let's take another example. I'll tell you the temperature today is 35 degrees and the weather is bad. Now, the first statement which I made, the temperature is 35 degrees, is a true statement. It can be verified by thermometers or whatever. The temperature is 35 degrees, the weather is bad. What about the second statement?
We are very happy, I am very comfortable.
Maybe he is comfortable.
But you said bad.
Okay, I said bad, it registers in your subconscious mind. 35 is bad. So next time when there is temperature of 35 degrees, you will get some irritation in your body. Because your unconscious mind has been programmed. 35 degrees means bad. 35 is only an hypothetical example I am giving. You could say 50. If the temperature is 50 degrees, weather is bad. Imagine temperature 50 degrees, what about the chap who is selling ACs? Is it bad for him? Right? So we just make these relations. Your husband, you will always fight. Somebody must have told you, Husbands always fight. So the first time he fought with you, yeah, husband, no, he will always fight. So that is already in your unconscious mind. Husbands always fight. Wives always fight. I mean, I'm just giving you examples.
You're right.
Sasbo. Right. So these are different this thing. So basically our mind is already conditioned. Our unconscious mind is already conditioned with that. And then we related, you know, x is equal to y.
I feel this education should be given in schools right from the child.
Sir, I'm trying very desperately to get into schools, but I'm not able to. I wish somebody can put me there once in a week.
This is a very important subject which you should address to school children. So they are the future citizens of our country, and they will know how to behave in the family.
Yeah, it's very important because, you see, now I'll tell you how to break this pattern also. Temperature is 50 degrees, the weather is bad. Now, before this settled in your unconscious mind, you must say temperature is 50, yes, I can check on the thermometer, but who says weather is bad?
But moment,
50 is a fact. 50 is a fact. I can check it from the thermometer. So I can't deny that.
Fact is not challenged, but the response is
challenged. Response is challenged, not the fact. Fact cannot be challenged. Sun rises in the east, everybody knows. Facts cannot be challenged. There are certain truths which cannot be challenged. Right? Thermometer will tell you temperature is 50. You cannot challenge that. But the day is bad or the weather is bad, you can always challenge that. So if you put that challenge, day is bad, who says? The AC chap is quite happy selling ACs. And you say yes. So your mind is not going to register that the temperature is 50 means weather is bad, or your body will not give you an irritation when it reaches 50 next time because it's not settled in your unconscious mind. So if the husbands always fight, says who? Maybe your husband fights, not mine. If you are told this statement, and again, you don't have to say this loudly to the other person. You have to say this in your mind. You have to give the suggestion to your mind. You have to understand. Her husband may be fighting, her mind doesn't fight. So next time, even when your husband fights, maybe a one-off case. It's okay.
Doesn't matter.
So it is how we are programmed, how we are, and as you rightly said, from childhood we are getting negative conditioning.
Absolutely.
What happens with children? We always tell them, don't go out and play. You will in the rain, you will play in the rain and you will get sick. So don't go out and play. Right? We always say what not to do. Don't sit and watch TV. Don't sit and play video games. You are saying what not to do. Why don't you say what to do?
See this program. Or go and get wet and feel.
Why don't you say what to do? If you say what to do, instead of telling a child, don't do this, tell a child, sit here, study, or sit here, and you want some entertainment, listen to music, sit here, do this, then the child knows what to do. If you keep saying what not to do, the child keeps wondering what to do. If I tell you, don't get angry, then what to do?
And the child will think, okay, maybe the next thing I do again, she'll tell me not to do this.
Yeah.
Break.
Communication is broken. Actually, so we need to say what to do.
There is no such thing as generation gap. It's the communication gap.
Exactly, sir. Very right. It's communication
people
gap.
People escape it. They want to say it's generation gap. The parents have to change for the children. The children don't have to change for the parents.
Sir, the child does not do what he is told. The child does what he sees. You tell a child, don't smoke. Smoking is bad for health. And then you smoke. You think the child is going to listen to you?
No.
If not in front of you, he will hide and smoke. Because he is going to, you tell the child, you know, crushing and throwing papers on the street is bad. Don't do it. And then next day he sees you crushing and throwing some ice cream cup or something. He is going to copy that.
My neighbor smokes, you know, and he had this child growing up. Now he is a 50-year-old. He said, but you know, he had this problem smoking and drinking. He said, see, when my son was in college, I told him, he told his son, I have a problem drinking and smoking, but I know it's not good. It's not good for me. I would advise you not to drink and smoke because I got addicted to it. But however, it is your choice. But given a choice, I would not do it. He said, I told him, and today the son doesn't smoke or drink.
See, that's one way.
The father admitted it was an addiction.
Yeah.
It was something that was wrong. And then they say, from my experience, I will only advise you. I can't tell you not to do it because I'm doing it.
Exactly. Idea is the decision should be with the other person, because if you take a decision, you take responsibility for your decision.
And
That's very important. If you don't take a decision, and if I take a decision for you, you will not take responsibility for it. Instead, you will tell me how it is not possible. Daddy, if he says don't smoke, Daddy, but my friend smoke. And you're smoking. So why can't I smoke? Yeah. Yeah. So these things will keep coming in. In fact, a better way, I mean, this is one way, what he did is right, good, very good. But another way, I won't even say better, another way of doing it is, you tell the child, whenever you won't feel like drinking and smoking, you come and sit with me. So sit with him.
And we can share a drink together, exactly.
Give him a drink and believe me, the bitterness of the whiskey or whatever. Exactly, you will get that response. As even our friend here, what's your name, sir?
Firoz,
as Wadia sir was saying, he tried and I'm sure his son must not be drinking.
And you know, this I read in the Reader's Digest before I was married.
Okay.
No problem. So I followed it in my married life.
Good, good.
Yeah. I was having a drink, my 5-6-3-year-old and then he can drink, I gave him neat.
He will never drink after that. Because now what happens, in his unconscious mind, it is programmed that this is bitter. Ye kadwa hai.
I don't want to try it again.
Same way smoke, when he smokes, that's initially when a person smokes, he inhales quite a lot of smoke. That will cause irritation and coughing. And then he'll become, you know, totally repulsive to smoking. In fact, not only that, he will not smoke, he will not be in company of people who smoke.
Secondhand
smoke is also bad. Passive smoking is also not good. So the question is how we train them, how we bring them up. That is very important.
They don't realize the repercussion it has on the children. How they go to school that day, how it affects their life, but they must still fight.
Sir, if you want to fight with your wife, I'll tell you a simple thing. Keep your children away, go to the bedroom, lock the door and fight. Children should not see it. No, I mean, keep them away meaning send them out to play or send them to school or maybe wherever they are going. Fight in their absence. By saying closed door, that's what I mean. Not in their presence. See, life becomes whatever you make out of it. I know there are couples who actually do that. When they want to fight, they will say, not now, children are there after they go to school.
So much energy is wasted.
They sort out because...
They're fighting for the sake of fighting.
No, because
that is ego issue.
They're not fighting.
Bhala, iski saadi, meri saadi se safed kaise? That is ego issue, no? See, advertisements is another thing, you know, which creates ego. Raymond, the complete man. So if you don't wear Raymond, you are not a complete man. So these are a lot of things which are playing on your ego. The advertisements play on your ego. Right? Same way fighting, anger, it plays on your ego. I want to prove my point, so I'm fighting. I'm not fighting because it is required, but because I want to say what I'm saying is right. Sir, they do come, but if you are mature human beings, which you are, by the time you get married, you should be mature enough.
Money problems do come.
But then they can be sorted out.
No, but my paisa lao, paisa lao.
Sir, I'll tell you again why that comes in. Because we live beyond our means. Now, I'll tell you something. We actually buy things, rather spend money which we have not earned. That means we buy things on EMI. So, we spend money which we have not earned. To buy things which we don't need. Sometimes, so many things are lying at home, how many times have you used them? To impress people we don't like. My neighbor has got Audi, I will get something better than that. Mercedes Benz.
And then
what happens? When you go for that, you don't have the money, so you buy on EMI. Right? And then paisa lao. Paisa nahi hai, toh EMI kahan se dega? नहीं तो वो बैंक वाला आके गाड़ी लेके जाएगा। So these are the things which happen.
I've been telling maids in my building whoever that please don't be under that stupid impression कि दिवाली के दिन में नया कपड़ा पहनो, change yourself, change your attitude. And it took time for me to explain a couple of years. Now they are blessing me. दिवाली पर नया कपड़ा मिस कपड़ा चाहिए नहीं
चाहिए।
You wear good decent clothes every day. Make every day your Diwali.
Every day should be Diwali.
This also is one of the major reasons of unhappiness.
Yes, it is there very much. See, we are, as I said, desires and expectations are not being met.
So-called religious belief or something, I don't know, what is the ideology behind the Diwali par naya kapra hona hi chahiye?
See, basically it has been started again. I'll tell you, sir, this becomes a stress factor. And this stress started after Industrial Revolution. Yeah, it started, I'm telling you.
Valentine's Day is also commercialized. Now, what is about Valentine's
Day?
See, people are dining and all that, you know, five-star hotels will give you a 10-course dinner for $10,000.
That's what I was saying. Basically, what happened is, there is... You know, today I heard something on the WhatsApp, RJ Navid from Radio Mirchi or something. He's speaking to somebody. He says, you are in a relationship with your girlfriend for the last 7 years. Yes. How many times have you taken her out for dinner? One day dinner is so much expense. So 1 month you go twice. So much per year. 7 years, so much. And finally, he's made a big total. You've given her dresses. You've given her roses. You've given her blah, blah, blah. And he says, in 7 years, you have spent more than 50 lakh rupees on your girlfriend. Now, what is that? Is that not again satisfying your ego? I am giving more to my girlfriend than what you are giving to your girlfriend. So basically, the stress, as I was saying, I started with the Industrial Revolution. What happened was, before Industrial Revolution, we were only doing on need basis. I need wheat, I grow wheat. Or I have got something, he's got wheat, I will exchange. Initially, there was barter system to begin with. When Industrial Revolution happened, production went up. We want to sell these goods. Then started advertising.
Artificial demand
has to be created. No, sir. Before Industrial Revolution, there was no stress. No, because as I said, naya kapda kyun chahiye? Who started naya kapda chahiye?
I don't know.
The clothes companies.
Oh, really?
The companies who manufacture clothes, they have to sell it.
So, not the pandits.
Pandits have just flown with the system.
Commercialized.
Pandits are also being commercialized with the system. And then what happens? Sab, maine iske ghar pe puja kiya, inhone mere ko naya dress diya. So that's how even pandits talk. Right? I'm sure some of you must have experienced it, what I'm saying. Dakshana. Not only that, utensils. Sab, inke ghar mein humne puja ki thi, inhone humko naya बर्तन दिया था पूजा के लिए, फिर वो ले जाने को भी बोला. अभी आपके घर में मैं आ रहा हूँ पूजा करने के लिए, आपको चाहिए तो इनसे आप पूछ सकते हो क्या क्या इन्होंने दिया, कैसे कैसे किया. सो दैट्स हाउ कंडीशनिंग एवरीथिंग इट ऑल इज बिकम कमर्शियलाइज्ड आफ्टर दैट. एज आई सेड, रेमंड, व्हाई डिड इट हैपन? रेमंड द कंप्लीट मैन. इन बिटवीन देयर वाज अ न्यू कार लॉन्च्ड बाय वन ऑफ द कार कंपनीज, आई डोंट रिमेंबर विच वन. मेन आर बैक, दैट वॉज द टैगलाइन. That means if you don't drive that car, you are not a man.
Yeah.
So what is that?
If you don't use Gillette, you are not.
Gillette, the macho man. And then that some soft drink ad comes, you know, dar ke aage jeet hai. Believe me, dar ke aage maut hai, yaar, jeet nahi hai. Yes, agar yahan pe saap aa gaya, I mean saap aa gaya to chodo. When I said saap aa gaya, I'm sure all of you must have already imagined a snake. Black snake, somebody may be even imagining sitting like this. Right, niche dekhne ko lage, couple of you. So the basic idea is that the word itself is settled in our mind, and the advertisements, all that they give you in unconscious mind. So they all settle there. When you go out and you are thirsty, believe me, you will not drink what you want. You will drink what is settled in your unconscious mind. Kya some bujhai pyaas? Which drink is that?
Sprite.
Bujhai pyaas. Baki all bakwas. Yeah. So these catchy taglines settle in your unconscious mind. And then when you go, you will say, arey, yaar, pyaas lagi, ek sprite dana. So that's how it goes. Exactly, because that's settled in your mind.
And you know, Coca-Cola, they came up with this brainwave, because before people would say, thanda ya garam,
haan.
Then they said, thanda matlab coke.
Thanda matlab coke, haan.
I mean, I thought that was too good.
And thanda matlab baraf bhi ho sakta hai.
Happy days are here again. Because
these are advertisement stunts which get into us.
Exactly, sir.
Using
we are.
And it makes us pay for it. I mean, yeah. Using the terminology, and they have interposed.
Exactly. And all this then ultimately has led to expenses.
Yeah, of course.
And that is what leads to stress. That is what we started with, you know. Money law. Sir, when I was going to school.
Maybe not the wife, meet the children.
Children. When I was going to school, I remember my pocket money, of course, that was a long bag. I'm talking of, say, 70s, early, late 60s, early 70s, somewhere there. I was going to school. My pocket money used to be about 50 paisa. If I had 1 rupee, I was rich. Even if you look at proportionality and you give the index and all those things, today 1,000 rupees. In my school time, I never thought of having a thumbs up or having any of these. At the most, ganne ka juice. That used to be the affordable drink, and that was, everybody was happy with that. Today, thumbs up and all whatever drinks are there, and people are still not happy. And sugarcane juice, mind you, is still more healthy than any of the other drinks. Dil mange more. Okay, so I was just talking about the anger and NLP also. That's nice that you brought this up.
Anger can be calmed by drinking water or some cold drink.
Yes, sir. Not cold drink, water. Take, this is the first one. Take a deep breath. The most common technique to calm down. Because what you are doing is, now this is in the initial phase. I'm not talking of later on. Immediately. If you take a deep breath and you should count till... Idea is, of course, keep your mouth shut, take a deep breath and count till 50. When I say count till 50, idea is keep your mouth shut.
That's most important.
Count till 50 doesn't mean 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 50. Come on, your anger has already gone up. Right? So take a deep breath, be calm, that's the idea. Keep your mouth shut, count till 50. You will automatically calm down. So this is in the initial phase, one of the techniques. Right? Postpone the discussion. That's what I told my friend. Biscuit khayega, pani piyega, baad mein baat karte hain, baad mein jhagda karte hain. So you are postponing the discussion. Right? Okay, that's one. Drink water. The very next thing. That's what I told him also. Biscuit khana though was basically just to, you know, break the pattern. Basically it was drink water. In his case I told him one glass. But if you can drink 3-4, do that. As much as you can drink. Don't worry. Water can never harm you. In fact, doctors will tell you 6 liters, 8 liters.
That's a myth. That is a myth. Please remove that myth.
Well, I'm just saying, doctors do tell you that.
No.
How much water should a man drink?
You should only drink when you're thirsty.
Okay.
And only drink itself. I can prove it.
I fully believe you. Yeah, we are not. Yeah, you're thirsty, you're dehydrated, so...
Because drinking too much water has also repercussions on the liver.
Yeah, it will have. Ultimately, the load will come there. It has to be...
There are many factors about water. It's the climate, it's your profession, it's your tendency, it's your DNA. There are millions and millions of things. So don't follow rigid rules. It's up to be your pani pine ka.
Not the rigid rules.
These are all spam messages which are circulating.
Not rigid rules, but again, I'll tell you, my doctor.
Body is made of 70% water. So
no, not that. When I had constipation in Britain, and my doctor told me, he says, what you do is try it, drink about 3 glasses of water, and pace up and down, and that seemed to have worked with me.
A couple were fighting. So one of the counselors said, you know, I'll give you take some haldi, nimak, and gargle your mouth.
Pura jal jayega yaar.
For 5 minutes, one more. And then this says, doctor, really worked. Your formula is very good. So doctor, it is not the aldi and namak, it is because you kept your mouth shut.
That's exactly. That's what was here. Keep your mouth shut.
That's the best.
Yeah. Basic idea is to keep your mouth shut. What he said is very right. Okay. So this was the next thing I said. When you are angry, drink water, because basically it is... Obviously, I have not written yet, that doesn't mean warm water, normal water, not even cold. But it cools down your feelings, basically. Okay.
Normally, 2 or 3 liters is enough per day.
Yeah, should be. 3 liters, I think, should be enough.
Yes.
But as you were saying, get into forced drinking of water. Now, this is the other thing, whenever this thing happens,
color of the urine is clear and not on yellow.
If
the color of urine is yellow, it makes an indication that you are lacking water.
Yeah.
But if the moment the color of the urine is okay, normal, that means you have sufficient
Normal meaning colorless.
Colorless. Provided you are not taking any vitamin tablets. Because vitamin, if the moment you take vitamin tablets, the color of the urine
will change.
The
yeah.
Vitamin color comes.
In fact, if you take.
That's a very important clause.
In fact, if you take iron tablets, your stools also color changes.
Yeah.
It will happen. Yeah. Okay, so I was saying whenever some things are going wrong, you start thinking of happy memories, things which have made you smile. That's coming next. Yeah, that's coming next. But right now, right, see what happens is, one is immediate step, one is even subsequently. So when you are getting angry, when you start thinking of these things, maybe the day you got married, the day you got your first child, or maybe the day you got your first salary. So whatever makes you happy, maybe you won some trophy somewhere, something like this. So whatever makes you happy, think of those memories. That will make you happy. Again, same thing, change the pattern. That's what we are looking at in this also. Change the pattern. Listening to music, this is another stress buster, as they call it. Even when you are angry, today everybody, almost everybody has headphones. But ideally, I will say don't use headphones, because somebody might tell you, and it's a fact that too much use of headphones can damage your ears, which is
brain
a fact.
Brain,
yeah.
Also.
Brain also.
Recent study is the brain.
Yeah. So best is listen to music with a... Especially on if you are walking. This is as shown there, sitting and listening to music. Oh, we had accidents.
Fatal ones,
yeah.
The music is the mobile on the ear.
Mobile, that's another, it's become a major issue these days.
People falling down from buses.
In fact, I have seen people being stopped, in the cars being stopped because they were talking on the mobile phone.
It has become mandatory now.
Yes.
You can't speak.
Can't speak on the phone, not even with Bluetooth. Huh? Okay, so basically sit and listen to music. This is, as I said, a good stress buster. Unwind. Talk to yourself.
You will think you are bad.
No.
That's the best.
Go to the bathroom and do it. Don't have to sit and do it in front of somebody else. Go to the bathroom and do it.
Somebody says, no, when I need expert advice,
I talk to myself, yeah.
The best thing to do.
Talking to myself for introspection.
Same thing.
Suppose you hate me. I must not hate you. I must try to find out why you hate me. That's talking to myself.
That's introspection.
Yeah. So introspection is better.
Talking to yourself meaning, instead of shouting at others, you talk to yourself. So it is, talk to yourself is again internal. It is not external.
It doesn't backfire. Because if you go and talk to yourself, you are also talking to yourself.
No, but then when you talk to yourself, as he rightly pointed out, you will get into introspection. Usne aisa kyun kiya? That will come automatically. It will not take long.
Usne kyun kiya is one thing, but how I deal with it. You get an answer, your intuition.
Yeah, how basically you...
Your own inner intelligence will answer, give you an answer how to deal with the situation. When you're talking to yourself, you're vibrating at a different level. You're not really using words.
See, basically talking to yourself means you are with your thoughts.
You are
with your thoughts. The other person cannot influence your thinking.
Exactly.
That's what we are talking about.
Exactly. And right? Then there's clarity of thought.
Yeah, clarity of thought is also there.
No, what I was getting at is when people stand there, seeing people are standing, and you cannot stand up for it. You cannot take it lying down. You have to go and answer. Go and reply.
That's
what are you doing standing
there? Wrong.
That's a very wrong thing.
I've seen people doing that, talking to themselves, but they talk this way. I mean, what the hell do you think? Why does anybody show you down? You go back and reply. Go, and then they go that.
That is again same thing. In childhood, maybe you were conditioned that way.
Silence is golden.
Childhood, maybe you were conditioned that way. That's why. Okay. See, when I say look at yourself in the mirror here, the first point, it is for you. If your wife is angry or your husband is angry, please don't show him the mirror. Believe me, he'll take the mirror, or he or she will take the mirror and break it on your head only. Right? So it is for you. Have a look at the mirror and see how you look. And if you want to look that way, then continue getting angry. You will yourself not like your look.
No, that's tortured.
Yeah. This is the other thing. Step out.
Go for a walk.
Basically, you need fresh air. Right? So step out, go for a walk. These are long-term measures for anger control. Of course, you could also join some yoga and meditation classes, but they are long term. But I've got something else. Besides yoga and meditation, I call something known as calm breathing. I'll come to that. It is, you can say, the very first step of meditation actually. Now this is another important thing. Once you feel that anger is mellowed down, you need to sit and talk. You need to sit and discuss the issue. Because unless the issue is sorted out, the anger will not go out. You are angry on some issue. At that point of time, you have postponed the discussion. When you are cool, when you are calm, you need to talk it out and say, okay, what was the issue? What we are talking about is this, this, this. This is what we need to do. With a calm mind, you will find better solutions. As I said, with a calm mind, you will be able to tap your resources, which normally you may not be able to tap when you are angry.
I was very friendly with one person, and then somehow there was this misunderstanding and I got very angry. Anyway, then after 2 years, I told her I would like to talk to you, and she said, no, I don't want to talk to you.
It's okay.
That's it. But the thing is that I made the attempt.
Yeah.
That is what, the you know, it reaches closure. That's it. I made the attempt, because until I told her, it was still playing on my mind. Now after she said she didn't want to talk to me, that didn't bother me at all, because I just wanted to talk to her. That's all.
Yeah, and you see now,
she may be continuing with the anger.
Exactly. I was just going to come to that. Now you will be calm that I told her she doesn't want to talk, it's her problem.
Exactly.
But she will continue with the anger.
Exactly.
She will keep saying, why did she want to talk to me?
Whatever, I don't know.
That's a different
what
issue.
As far as I'm concerned,
you have made efforts, good.
Yeah, I made one effort. That's it. After that I didn't.
Yeah, you don't have to keep making efforts. If she doesn't want to talk, it's okay. As far as you're concerned, matter is over. Yes, you will feel relieved, because you have done your bit.
Exactly.
It's up to her. If she doesn't want to do it, it's her problem, not yours. Yeah. This is what calm breathing. That's my phone ringing. It'll go off only. Basically, what we say, calm breathing.
See, your lecture is effective. Nobody is getting annoyed.
Yeah. I have got my results, isn't it? Even I am not bothered. It will go off. Even I am not bothered. See, now when you say calm breathing, what is calm breathing? See, you must have heard about, you know, a lot of people saying breathe from the left nostril or right nostril or deep breathing or shallow. I am not telling you anything. I am only saying, calm breathing means whatever is your normal breath, keep it that way. Don't try to deep breathe. Don't try to shallow breathe. Don't try to breathe fast. Nothing. All that you need to do is watch your breath. And as it goes in, one, out. Again in, two.
Very calming. Immediate effect. I do that every time.
If you can do that till...
Even when I'm not angry.
No, this is not when you're angry. This is not when you're angry. You can do this anytime. And by any time, I really mean any time.
Any time, any place, anywhere.
Because any time means before food, yes. Immediately after food, yes.
Anytime. Even now.
Even now. Because you are not forcing your breath. You are not, you know, if you do deep breathing or if you do some pranayama or whatever, then they will tell you, you know, so much time after food, don't do. Here you are not doing anything. It's your normal breath. All that you are doing is counting your breath and being aware of it. That's all. But this is not only when you're angry, this is any time you can do.
When I focus on my breath, it tends to be longer and deeper.
Yeah.
It tends to be.
Automatically. Yeah. It will happen automatically, but you don't try to make it.
No, it just happens.
And secondly, you will find that in the, let's say before you do this, let's say for about 1 minute, you count your breath. And that is 15. You do this, count till 50. And then you count your breathing again. It will automatically have come down to maybe 14 or even 13. That's it. It will not come down to 10. Don't expect that kind of a thing. It will come to 13. But if you do this for 6 months, 8 months, maybe a year, it will come down to 10 breaths per minute.
I believe it can even cure your heart ailment.
Yes, you can.
By this simple technique.
Simple technique. You can do a lot of things by this.
But continue your medicine, but do this also.
Yes, yes. I never say stop medicine. Medicine should stop automatically. Your doctor should, you should feel the need. Your doctor should tell you, no, now you're okay, you don't need medicine. So you should do this on the side without even telling your doctor.
Doctor should suppress.
And basically you are not doing anything. You are just sitting and counting your breath, that's all. So many things, so many things. It's a very nice system. Calm breathing is an excellent technique. Practice it. 99.9% you will succeed in whatever you want. It's only that 0.1% because that margin we have to give. You never say 100%. Right? So your anger will come down. Your stress level will come down. And you will find yourself automatically taking things easy. You know, life is too fast. That's what we are doing. Living very fast. Yes, exactly. We have done it. So we need to now slow down.
Somebody said, you know, it is not the length of time that you live, but the number of breaths. Your life is dependent on it. So it makes sense to...
So if you reduce your number of breaths, you will anyway live longer, isn't it? Maybe because they breathe very fast, yeah. When you are doing exercise and all, you do breathe fast.
Another thing is laughing.
Laughing automatically, no, sir, again...
Laughing at yourself.
Laughing at yourself is the best.
No, just burst out in laughter.
Basically, your muscles, when you are laughing, your muscles get activated.
The endorphins in your body increase.
Yeah.
Endorphins are natural resistance to your...
to the external infections coming in. Very, very right. So, basic idea is that, you know, more use of your muscles for at time of laughing, deep breathing, not deep breathing, calm breathing. Deep breathing and all, if you want to go into yoga or meditation and then whatever they teach you, it's very much in place. I'm not against anything, but I would prefer and practice calm breathing.
Oh, thank
right, Jeremy. Any more questions, anything you have?